Welcome to this brief guide on how to manage Windows on macOS with Rectangle. Generally speaking, managing Windows on macOS is not quite as fully fleshed out as it is on other platforms such as Windows, and managing multiple applications can be a bit of a pain. So today I'm going to show you a program called Rectangle to make that a thing of the past. Here I have the website for Rectangle open, and I'll include a link to it in the description of this video. We're going to download this program, and it is worth noting it requires macOS 10.13 or newer and supports both Intel and Apple Silicon based Macs. There is also a pro version, which is a paid upgrade, but in this particular demonstration, we're just going to focus on the free and open source version available here. The first thing you'll need to do is utilize the big download button and click on download to download the installation file. Once you've downloaded the installation file, simply find it in your Finder application and double click on it to begin the installation process. And just like other programs on macOS, simply drag it across to your applications folder to complete the installation. Super fast and super easy. And now we're just going to utilize Spotlight Search here just to quickly open up the application. And what you'll see is you get a prompt letting you know that this program was downloaded from the internet and you'll need to approve opening it. Select the open button to do so, and you'll notice in your menu bar you have a brand new icon, which is the icon for Rectangle. Selecting this will give you a context menu with lots of different options available to you, but first we're going to head all the way down to the bottom and we're going to select the option for preferences. This is going to let us choose our settings for the Rectangle application. The first page here is a lot of the available keyboard shortcuts, but if these don't meet your own needs, you can click into any of these boxes and record your own. The second page in the preferences will be the one that is most similar for those that are used to Windows. This is a version of Snap Assist, very, very similar, but with a lot more customization, such as being able to dictate what each of the different designated spots on your screen will actually do. I'm just going to change this back to the default. And then we're going to focus on the checkboxes at the top here. These are a few of the options where you can choose whether or not your window size is automatically resized to where they were when you unsnap. But the first thing to make sure is that the snap windows by dragging is enabled, otherwise this feature will not work. Then in the third and final page of the preferences here, we want to make sure that we select the option that says launch on login. This will make sure that the application is activated every time we log on to our device. Now, if you do happen to customize any of the settings inside here, you will notice here that we have the ability to export our custom settings and then import them. So if we move to a new device, we can always easily import our pre-configured shortcuts. Now that that's done, let's see this application in action. All I need to do is simply click and drag from the title bar of any of my applications to any of the designated zones on my Mac's desktop screen here. And then as you'll see, my applications have now automatically split 50-50 because of the fact that I've gone to the left-hand side and the right-hand side. However, Spotify here doesn't seem to have enough space, so I would actually like to give it 2/3 of my screen. This is a really nifty feature and one of my favorites that I use every day, where I can drag a window to the bottom of my screen and then across the bottom edge to allocate space by thirds. So here I've now given Spotify 2/3 of my screen, and then my web browser here, I can simply just do it to the other side and now I have that on 1/3 as well. This is super great for those that utilize an ultra-wide monitor and want to have a primary application and then a secondary application such as a messaging application or something like that. What you'll also notice though is that it integrates seamlessly into your standard abilities, such as double-clicking on the title bar to zoom any applications. So you can integrate this into your workflow without needing to disable any of the pre-configured settings as well. And that is how you use Rectangle to manage Windows on macOS. I hope you found this tip extremely useful and it makes managing the Windows on your Mac that much easier. And I'll catch you in my next video. Thanks for watching. If you'd like to see more content like this, be sure to check out the channel. And if you like what you see, don't forget to hit that subscribe button.